All right, welcome to Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am your host, Sean Anthony, broadcasting live every Sunday, 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And today's show is going to be out of this world, literally, out of this world. Very interesting article published in the New York Times. That's right, the New York Times put out an article, and it's pretty fascinating when you're talking about UFOs and black programs dealing with the government and stuff like that. This is about an 11-page article in the New York Times, just talking about glowing auroras and black money, the Pentagon's mysterious UFO program. I don't know if I said this publicly, but I'll make the statement today. Based off of the things that I've been monitoring here the past several months, articles I've been reading, I personally think in the next year, between 2018 and 2019, in the next year or two, we are going to see an influx of UFO activity to the point to where it's undeniable. Now, some out there will already believe that there are extraterrestrials out there in the universe, in the galaxies, and so on and so forth, especially UFOs, unidentified flying objects. Some people are like, oh, no, that's conspiracy. Oh, my goodness. You know, blah, 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 whatever. Some people are like, well, we already know. Well, yeah, it's kind of taboo because our government is all hush-hush about it. They don't really talk about it. But yet you get all of these personal accounts, all of these evidences and stories and documentations and over the years of UFOs and alien life form or what have you, making themselves real or appear. Numerous, countless stories, people talking about that they've been visited by extraterrestrials. I mean, you've heard all about it. But the United States government are the only ones that are really lax about it. In fact, this article in the New York Times talks about how other countries are more transparent and does not understand why the United States government isn't open about disclosing the information that they have about UFOs. Well, this article here, it talks about it. It really talks about it. And I think it's something worth paying attention to. It talks about these big budgets, right, that the Defense Department has. It's like $600 billion. Out of that $600 billion, there's $22 million that was spent on what it's called the Advanced Aerospace Threat Identification Program. And the article says how it was almost impossible to find, which is how the Pentagon wanted it. So for years, the program, the article says, investigated reports of identified flying objects, according to the Defense Department officials, interviews with program participants, and records obtained by the New York Times. It was run by military intelligence. And they said it was on the fifth floor, deep into the Pentagon's building maze or what have you. But the Defense Department has never before acknowledged the existence of the program, which says it was shut down in 2012. Excuse me. But it's a shadowy program. Parts of it renamed classified began in 2007. Initially, it was largely funded at the request of Harry Reid, who is the Democrat from Nevada, who was in the Senate, who was the Senate Majority Leader at the time. And he was pretty much strongly interested in this whole UFO, extraterrestrial, alien phenomenon. Now, this is where it really gets interesting for me personally, because we're going to start like diving into some of these, taking little rabbit trails to put some of this information together. The money went to a research company that was ran by a billionaire, that's still running by a billionaire entrepreneur, Robert Bigelow. Robert Bigelow is currently working with NASA to produce expandable craft for humans to use in space. Now, let me pause right there, because we're going to talk about Mr. Bigelow here in a minute. I just want to tie in some of the things that we've been talking about here on Floor of Wisdom for the past several months. Elon Musk, to be more specific, he's been pro, you know, trying to create affordable ways for average citizens or whatever to travel into space. So you have these billionaires that are putting up the money and investing in the technology and investing into the research and being very transparent with the public about these things and working with NASA. But yet our government has been so hush about this. Why is that? Why do you think that our government doesn't want to disclose all of this information with the public? Now, let me say this, from doing research and stuff, there's been information out there saying that, hey, our government has been working with aliens for decades in underground bases. If you guys would check out any interview that I've done over the years with my friend Wilbur Allen, who's a photographer, his work has appeared on the History Channel. He appears on the History Channel, the Weather Channel, National Geographic, so many others. He also worked as an engineer for Air Force One under the Clinton administration, if I'm not mistaken, Clinton or Bush Jr. administration on Air Force One. But he's been on this show numerous times, and he believes that there are, in fact, underground alien bases, alien bunkers. Okay. He photographs unidentified flying objects in the skies outside of his home, which is in Washington, D.C., on a daily basis. You could check out his photos at ufodc.com. I actually sent him a little note here prior to going live. I tagged him in this article. By the way, if you want to look at this article and read it for yourself, because we're going to go through it, this one and a couple of other articles, but it's on facebook.com/flowofwisdom. Go there, like the page, and share the articles, please. Share all the information that I put up there. I would greatly appreciate it. So let's go back to Mr. Robert Bigelow. He's the billionaire entrepreneur, made his money through, hotels, I think it was. Then he started his aerospace program. But Mr. Bigelow appeared in a 60 Minutes interview several months ago, and they asked him, you know, how does he feel about this? And he said he is absolutely convinced that aliens exist and that UFOs have visited the Earth. In fact, doing a little bit more, he had an encounter in Nevada. So You know, this multimillionaire, Robert Bigelow, claims that aliens visited his family. He's got friends in high places. And he's all in. He's all in about exploring the exploration of space to get down to the bottom of this with aliens. He says that there is a strong extraterrestrial presence on our planet. Are you guys open to this ideology? Do you believe that there is a strong extraterrestrial presence on our planet? Other research will tell you that there's different kinds of aliens out there. You've got the reptoids or whatever. I don't know. I don't have that list in front of me. But apparently there are different types of aliens out there. Different alien species. But I believe in the very near future, especially in 2018, we're going to see heavy activity. We're going to see heavy activity out of space. When we come back, we're still going to continue into this article in the New York Times, but I'm going to share with you a personal story of when I seen an unidentified flying object. And if you have a story, I'd like to hear yours as well. 877-300-7645. I'm Sean Anthony. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio. We'll be back. May 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Hey, what happened to my music, man? I kind of cut it off abrupt. Yeah, that's okay. It's okay. Let it fade out, brother. You got to let the music ride, man. It's all good. Oh, man. 877-300-7645. Listen, quick story about, you know, unidentified flying objects. I was working on the radio in Richmond, Virginia, doing the night show. I got off the air. I got off the air at 10 p.m. So clearly this was after 10, right? I'm leaving the radio station and I hop on 64 West. 64 West going towards Charlottesville. Anyone that has ever traveled through Richmond or what have you, 64 East takes you to Va Beach, Virginia Beach. 64 West takes you, you know, to Charlottesville, on to West Virginia, etc. So we're on 64. Me and my son, my oldest son. And out of nowhere, this was far. It was really, really high up in the sky. It was this small orange light, and it shot up. It was just kind of moving straight up, and then it slowed down and stopped, and then it took a quick right turn, and just it was gone. It happened so quick. I looked at my son. I was like, did you just see that? Because I was tripping. I'm driving. I couldn't believe my eyes. And he confirmed that he's seen exactly what I seen. So I knew I wasn't tripping, you know. Now, what was that? I have no idea. Was that an alien? I have no idea. But it definitely was a UFO. An unidentified flying object. I could not identify it. Now, some people will say, look, our military, our Air Force, has the type of technology and equipment that can maneuver like that. Maybe so. I haven't seen it. I don't know. But I will tell you, I flew on lots of airplanes, and no airplane I flew in has never maneuvered like that. So it just brings up lots of peculiar questions. people are, you know, are concerned. We want to know. And why don't our government just come out and talk about it? So anyway, there's been others that have had encounters with extraterrestrial species. Like, again, my friend Wilbur Allen, who's been on the show numerous times, he shared his story when he was very, very young. And there's others out there that have had that kind of experience. I hope I'm not going too far-fetched for y'all. You know, I've covered these subjects before, but it's not as often. But I really believe here in the very near future, we're going to start hearing more and more stories like this. It's going to become transparent with us. And hopefully the government will just open up and be honest with us and confirm and let us know. But anyway, this article in the New York Times, and there's some video in the article as well that I would definitely recommend you guys checking it out. It's on my Facebook page on Flow of Wisdom. And you can see some of the, there was an object where two fighter jets, there were Navy F-18F fighter jets that were chasing after this whitish oval object, it says. It says it was about the size of a commercial plane. And the two Navy fighter jets chased this object off the coast of San Diego in 2004. So anyway, Harry Reid, Democrat from Nevada, who was in the Senate, pushed and initiated this program that for the Defense Department to start investigating this advanced aerospace threat identification program. $22 million that the Defense Department budgeted for, and they hit it because it's a, you know, a black project. We don't want a lot of people knowing about it. We'll continue with this information after we take this quick break. Don't go anywhere. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio. All right, welcome back. Flow of Wisdom Radio. Sean Anthony here. All right, let's get into this interesting part of the article here in the New York Times. You know, we're talking about these black money projects, glowing auroras and black money, the Pentagon's mysterious UFO program. So I know I mentioned that the Democrat from Nevada, Harry Reid, who was really behind launching this black program, and it's been funded by a company from a gentleman by the name of, who's an entrepreneur, businessman, Robert Bigelow, and it's his company that's really spearheading some of these the research and preparing, you know, for ships to going up to space. But there was also this article was pretty thorough, because it's giving, you know, different perspectives. One, Sarah Seeger, who's an astrophysicist at MIT, cautioned, saying that not knowing the origin of an object does not mean it is from another planet or galaxy. When people claim, she says, to observe truly unusual phenomena, sometimes it's worth investigating seriously. What people sometimes don't get about science is that we often have phenomena that remain unexplained, which is good. That's fair. Fast forward here. Officials, this is in response to questions from the Times, Pentagon officials this month acknowledged the existence of the program, which began as part of the Defense Intelligence Agency. Officials insisted that the effort had ended after 5 years in 2012. So they finally coming out admitting that they've got this program. Well, they quote unquote had this program. It's no longer existed. It no longer exists. They knocked it off, nipped it in the bud in 2012 because they said, quote, they have higher priority issues that merited funding. So apparently they weren't getting allocating this huge portion of this $600 billion to this particular program. Okay. Then it says, but Mr. Elizondo said in an interview, which he worked with officials from the Navy and the CIA, that he continued to work out of his Pentagon office until this past October, when he resigned just to protest what he characterized as excessive secrecy and internal opposition. He asked a question, why aren't we spending more time and effort on this issue? And this was a resignation letter that he wrote to Defense Secretary Jim Mattis. UFOs have been repeatedly investigated over the decades in the United States, including by the American military. The article points out in 1947, the Air Force Base began a series of studies that investigated more than 12,000 claimed UFO sightings before it was officially ended in 69. The project, which included a study codenamed Project Blue Book, some of you may be familiar with that, which started in 1952. It concluded that most sightings involved stars, clouds, conventional aircraft, or spy planes, although 701 remained unexplained. Robert Siemens Jr., the Secretary of the Air Force at the time, said in a memorandum announcing the end of Project Blue Book that it no longer can be justified either on the ground of national security or in the interest of science. Mr. Reed said his interest in UFOs came from Mr. Bigelow, the billionaire, the entrepreneur, which was in 2007, Mr. Reed said in an interview. Mr. Bigelow told him that an official with the Defense Intelligence Agency approached him wanting to visit Mr. Bigelow's ranch in Utah, where he conducted research. When Mr. Reed said he met with agency officials shortly after the meeting with Mr. Bigelow and learned that they wanted to start a research program on UFOs, Mr. Reed then summoned some other gentlemen, Mr. Stevens and Inouye, to a secure room in the Capitol. He said, I talked to John Glenn a number of years before. And that Mr. Reed said that he had told them he thought that the federal government should be looking seriously into UFOs and should be talking to military service members, particularly pilots who had reported seeing aircraft they could not identify or explain. All right, let me pause it right there. Number one, if we do have any pilots out here listening to the program, it would be really great for you guys to call into the show. Because I'm sure you guys must have seen something out there. Maybe you haven't. I don't know. I'm just curious. You're up there in those skies. You know, I just would really love to hear a story from a pilot or two to call in. 877-300-7645. Why is it so taboo? Why is it the government and the military so secretive? Why is this excessive secrecy, he said? And we should be talking about this. This should be at the forefront. You know, on another note, there was a, where was the article at? It was an article I was reading. Where did it go? It was saying, yeah, here it is, in physicsastronomy.com, that the Earth is getting hit by too much antimatter, and nobody knows why. is saying that the Earth has been getting hit by fast-moving, high-energy cosmic rays bursting off from outer space. These cosmic rays comprise positrons in a small proportion. They say in a greater amount, he said there's something more, in a greater amount, it's coming our way.
Tell him, should I send your message?
What? Here we go, Siri. Tripping again. Anyway, I think that this subject matter is interesting. And one, I think it sets the stage for what we're going to be covering on this show here in the next several weeks and in the very near future. Because eventually I'm going to get back into parallel universes, multi dimensions. And this is going to be tied into, you know, not only the subject matter that we're covering right now, but CERN, the Large Hadron Collider. Now, if you're not familiar with the Large Hadron Collider, don't worry about it. We'll definitely get you up to speed. For those that are, stay with me. In fact, I did a series earlier this year, the beginning of this year, on CERN, the Hadron Collider. Basically, it's a particle conductor. It smashes together. It collides protons, neutrons, atoms, all of that stuff. It collides them together, and they study what comes out of it. And we also, in that series we did, it was called CERN, D-Wave, and Technocracy. If you want to go back and check that out, go to the Flow of Wisdom YouTube channel, CERN, D-Wave, and Technocracy. It's about a six-part series that I did on the subject matter. But the D-Wave computer is the supercomputer, the world's strongest computer. And the large CERN, Large Hadron Collider is like the world's largest piece of equipment. But in fact, I think China's building one bigger. all of those are intertwined. And Gordy Rose, the guy who, the founder of D-Wave, the D-Wave computer, I mean, he's publicly talking about parallel universes, multi-dimensions, the fact that this quantum computer can tap into all of these different things, okay? And he even talked about recently summoning these demons through this technology. And I'm paraphrasing through all of this. But we're going to start taking our steps in that direction here in the next coming weeks. Guys, give me some feedback. I just hope that this stuff is interesting to you, because I get excited about it. And, you know, like I said, we've done this touched on this before, but we're going to go in more depth on this subject matter now. But I wanted to bring up this article, because I got it first thing yesterday, this article in the New York Times, and I'm like, wow, they're really confirming, you know, about these black projects and the black money. They call it the black money. It's the Pentagon's mysterious UFO program. I was like, wow, the New York Times. How about that? And these are all people that, you know, you can trace them. These guys worked in the government. Really, really interesting stuff. So you got all of this documentation out here. People are coming out who work within the government saying, look, let's put this out there. Let's talk about this. The technology is advanced. They're working on it to go in outer space. You know, what are your thoughts? 877-300-7645. We'll be back right after this. Flow of Wisdom. All right, welcome back. Flow of Wisdom Radio. Sean Anthony here, 877-300-7645. Let's get to the phone. Marcus in Toronto. What's up, Marcus? Welcome to Flow of Wisdom, man. How are you?
I'm okay. I was just wanted to say that if you're going to cover UFOs, they started doing foaming mercury research in the 20s and 30s, and that's like apparently the main ingredient in the UFOs that Lockheed Martin has been building for whoever the secret projects are being built for. And there's also some stuff on the internet for anti-gravity stuff. There's a guy spinning a barbell that apparently he can't lift, but once he starts spinning one end, he can lift it up in the air. But every time you get any research in that direction, it always gets hushed up, and Antarctica got closed off, whatever the heck is down there.
Yeah, I was just talking to a friend of mine this morning, and we were talking about Antarctica as well. You know, there's been a lot of activity in Antarctica, but go ahead.
I was going to say, whatever the activity is, nobody is being told about it.
Absolutely. And wasn't the Secretary of State, what's his name? John, what's the guy's name? Was over there during the Obama administration. He was over there in Antarctica. And then I read reports that Putin was over there as well, and one of the rabbis was over there. Did you hear anything about that? This was late last year. This was about a year ago.
Actually, if you noticed, a lot of celebrities have been going to Antarctica over the last year and a half and making a big scene of, I'm off to Antarctica, and like as if anybody can go there.
John Glenn over there. Right before John Glenn died last year, from my understanding, he went over there to visit Antarctica. Something's going on in Antarctica, and they're not telling us.
Yeah, like as if they found the hole to go into the center of the Earth. That's one conception. And the other one is that they found the end of the world, the firmament, past that. And naturally, you can't let people anywhere near whatever they found, because we're living on a globe. The moment you find anything in Antarctica that points in the other direction, see that? There goes your living on a globe. That's why it's off limits.
What do you mean we're living on a globe? I don't understand. What do you mean by
that? Well, I'm a flat earther, and I believe that the Earth is flat.
Okay.
And apparently anything that ever shows that the Earth is flat never makes it into modern media.
Yeah. Yeah, that's very controversial. You know, when you come out saying that publicly, and especially if you're like a celebrity or whatever, you get ostracized. They put you down, you know, in the public. But yeah, that's
basketball
really...
players lost contract.
Yeah, it was a Kyrie Irving. Would you say he lost the contract?
There was a few basketball players over the years that came out saying the Earth is flat. Shaq being one of them. But whoever said it, look at their careers now. They're not playing basketball. Whatever they're doing.
Kyrie Irving's he's playing ball in Boston. But then there's a rapper named B.O.B. He's been very vocal about that as well, and they kind of roasted him on Twitter about a year ago or maybe earlier this year. But he's still consistent as far as putting his thoughts out there on his social media platform. But yeah, I get it, man. You know, when you go against the popular, you know, the popular thoughts or ideology on things, you know, you kind of be like this black sheep, this, you know, ousted or what have you. But I don't know. It's all good. I mean, I did a show on the flat earth last year. I definitely will consider revisiting it. But Marcus, we got to wrap up this hour. Get ready for hour two. Thanks for the call, buddy. I appreciate it. That's Marcus in Toronto. Listen, be a part of the show. We got another hour. We're going to tap into, I'm going to break down what CERN, the Large Hadron Collider, is, and some of the things that, you know, D-Wave and how all of that stuff ties together, and multi-dimensions. We're going to really start getting into it, guys. Stick around 6 minutes past the top of the hour. We'll be right back after this. It's Flow of Wisdom. The show's about to begin, so you need to get motivated. Get motivated. Get motivated.